Modern wastewater treatment plants, or WWTPs as we call them, are capital intensive, requiring the use of innovative machinery and equipment. The high upfront capital investment used in wastewater treatment plants combined with unpredictable revenue streams make this a sector unfavorable for private investment. However, wastewater treatment can be made financially viable through leveraging public-private partnership. Here, government provide financial support to WWTPs, lowering their investment risk, whereas the private sector firms provide technical expertise and capital investment. Thus, PPPs are more cost-efficient and can be created at scale in comparison to purely government-run projects. The PPP model has been successful in Israel and Singapore. Both examples outline pertinent lessons for India. For instance, while Israel is a country that faces severe water scarcity due to its geography and location, it is now a global leader in recycled water reutilization. In fact, treated water met one-third of Israel's demand in 2015. There are several factors that lead to Israel's success. First, its integrated water authority and a newly introduced financial framework. The Israel's Water Authority, or IWA, established in 2007, is a national water planning body that regulates the country's freshwater, wastewater, and irrigation. The IWA ensures wastewater is optimally directed to water-intensive sectors. The authority also created a new financial network that integrates tariffs with cross-subsidies across user groups and financial incentives for operational performance. Second factor is subsidies for the construction of WWTPs. The IWA subsidizes the treatment and storage of recycled water. Around 18% of water tariff collections cover sewage cost and 4.5% covers subsidies. The third factor is farmer price subsidies. Farmers are offered treated water at a price lower than fresh water prices. The government subsidizes the conveyance cost of treated water, incentivizing the farmers to move away from freshwater use. Fourth is transparent regulation. The Israeli government has made information on water uses and prices publicly accessible, as well as specifying effluent quality standards and sewage treatment rules for better public health. Fifth and the final factor leading to Israel's success is technological innovation. The private sector is incentivized to deploy high-tech solutions in wastewater treatment. The indigenous firm Solidate, for example, uses sensor-equipped gauges to improve operational performance. Singapore, like Israel, is a water-scarce country. To meet its demand, it's dependent on Malaysia for water import. Nonetheless, the introduction of ultra-clean, high-grade, reclaimed treated wastewater source NE Water in 2003, Singapore meets 40% of its total water demand independently. There are four factors that mainly lead to New Water's success. Firstly, the country uses circular model. Four water reclamation plants conduct primary and secondary sewage treatment in line with international standards, whereas five new water treatment plants undertake tertiary treatment including microfiltration and reverse osmosis. This water is then piped to industries through a 515-kilometer transmission network. Industry effluents return to the sewer network after appropriate treatment, efficiently regenerating new water. Second factor is that the National Water Authority bears revenue risk. The private sector finances, constructs, and operates Singapore's four new water plants under concession agreements. The Public Utilities Board, or PUB, purchases new water at pre-agreed tariffs for the agreement duration, guaranteeing revenues for new water plants. Third is that the PUB prices water cover the cost of production, collection, treatment, and reuse, levying taxes to reflect water scarcity value and encourage conservation. Industrial users pay a lower tariff for new water than treated fresh water. Fourth and the final factor leading to Singapore's success is the performance-based procurement. The PUB uses new water quality as the key selection criteria rather than just the lowest provision cost. Next, we share some learnings from indigenous wastewater models. If If you find these insights useful, make sure to stay tuned for more by following our various social media platforms.